Hi and welcome, dear students and everyone else. These are the protocols released by the KHDA, that is Knowledge and Human Resource Authority in Dubai, for reopening of private schools in Dubai. It is in several parts. It comprises about 118 points, and I'll be sharing those in certain sections. The category A that is being read out today, it is about entry, pickup and school visit procedures. The pointers of the short descriptions are that modes of thermal screening individually or by installing of relevant technology should be present at the entrance of the school. Children who are taking the bus should get scanned for their temperature before getting onto the bus. Anyone with a fever of 37.5 degrees centigrade should not be allowed entry. The class teacher is responsible to refer the students to the school nurse for further screening if the teacher happens to see the COVID-19 symptoms such as cough, body aches, fatigue, shortness of breath, sore throat, runny nose, diarrhea, and nausea and headache. Teachers and students older than 6 years of age are required to wear face masks at all times. Staff will be discouraged from exiting the school during the day, but if they do for emergency purposes, they are requested not to return to the premises unless they are fully sanitized and change their clothes upon return. They will also undergo thermal screening before entry. Only one family member or a guardian is allowed to enter the school facility for drop off, pick up of his or her child. People with compromised medical conditions, including the elderly, should not come for drop off and pick up. The school should implement a staggered entry and exit procedures to eliminate overcrowding and to maintain 2 meters physical distancing in high traffic areas. Families drop off and pick up at one designated areas and designated timings with no interaction inside the school. There should be no access to the rest of the school facility by family members and visitors. Family members should be given maximum time of 10 minutes in the designated area to pick up, drop off with no crowding, maintenance of a 2 meter distancing and wearing of masks at all times. Meetings are encouraged to take place online unless there is a critical need for one-to-one meeting, which should take place on an appointment by email basis and will need to be made and approved beforehand. Maintenance work or deliveries should happen after school after the school's opening hours. Proper precautionary measures should be applied, especially for pickup or drop-off items, by designating a specific location and following the contactless process. Students are requested to use this piece of information for their literacy assignment. That means they will summarize the points using transitional words so that they are better aware and they remember these points very well. I hope this will be helpful, and the second part and third part, subsequent parts, are being uploaded. Please keep a track of all the parts, read it carefully, listen carefully, understand it, and if there are any questions, one can go to the KHDA Twitter and ask the question, or KHDA website and ask the questions. And if you are new to my channel, kindly subscribe to my channel, and if you like the sharing, kindly hit like and share it with family and friends. It's for safety and awareness. Please do share this. Thank you so much for your precious time. Welcome students to the second part of this protocol for reopening of private schools in Dubai. This is the second part, that is B, screening and contingency emergency plan. The pointers are that if a stable case of illness is detected amongst the visitors or staff presenting COVID-19 symptoms such as fever, 37.5 degrees centigrade, cough, body ache and fatigue, shortness of breath, sore throat, runny nose, diarrhea, nausea, headache or loss of sense of smell or taste, DHA hotline number 800-342 should be contacted by the school's designated health and safety officer. In case of emergencies such as having unstable cases among staff, students or visitors, the school should immediately contact 999 or 997. Health and safety designated staff should be identified and assigned to handle any emergency situation, follow up and monitor the implementation of health and safety procedures, and contact all necessary trainings for students and staff. This person is also responsible for the designated isolation room within the school premises. If a child, teacher, staff begins to show symptoms of COVID-19 while at school, they must get isolated instantly, and the parent guardian of the child should be notified immediately, and the patient should be referred to the hospital to take the necessary action. The patient should not return to school until the PCR result is obtained. If the result is negative and there is a clinical assessment of a probable COVID-19 case, the patient should complete a 14-day quarantine. If the result is negative and there is no clinical assessment for the probable case, the child can resume schooling as long as they are symptom-free. If the result is positive, the traced contacts of the patient, including the teachers, along with the classmates of a student or colleagues, are all considered close contacts. Anyone who spent about 15 minutes in a proximity of 2 meters within the positive case. From the day of the symptoms onset on the day of the positive PCR test, they should all commence a 14-day quarantine counted PCR from the day of the positive test or from the day of the onset of symptoms if ascertained by the clinical. In cases of COVID-19 emergency, the school should follow the endorsed guidelines for emergencies by the school's qualified nurse, doctors, while wearing adequate personal protection equipment. Also, the health and safety in charge should ensure that the child is accompanied by an adult wearing the full PPE when transported to home or to the hospital. Measure for disinfection should be taken as per the guidelines for the classroom and the school premises used by the child as traced, and holding isolation room where the staff and students will wait for the transportation. This is section B. It is shared for information for health and safety. Students are requested to use this, read this carefully, use it for their assignment, and share it with family and friends. It's for awareness. It will definitely help if you share this with family and friends. Thank you very much. Moving on to section C of the protocol for reopening of private schools in Dubai, and it is shared for students' awareness. Students are requested to read this carefully, listen to it, understand it, and if there are any questions, kindly go to KHDA website or Twitter and ask KHDA directly. It is shared for information for health and safety only, and students may use this information for their literacy assignment by rewriting, re-expressing, and using appropriate transitional language. The section is monitoring attendance and contact tracing. That is, if a staff, guest, or the students are confirmed positive according to a COVID-19 PCR test by an accredited facility, they are not to return unless they are granted a clearance certificate by DHA stating that they are discharged from the isolation. The school must maintain adequate records of its staff, guest, maintain members, students, including names, telephone numbers, and visit dates to assist if contact training becomes necessary, and to maintain accurate work records of its staff for contact tracing purposes. The school should abide by the contact tracing procedures by providing DHA with all records needed to trace potential contacts of the confirmed COVID-19 cases. Upon the onset of the academic year, the school should collect health and travel declaration forms from all students and staff. The template of the form can be developed by the school. A policy of staying at home if unwell for students and teachers and school staff with symptoms should be enforced. This is shared for information. If you like the information, kindly share it with family and friends. Even if you did not like it, please share it for the sake of safety of every person. Thank you very much. We'll proceed to the next section. Moving on to the next section of the protocol for reopening of private schools in Dubai, that is the section D. This is the most important section, that is hygiene. The short descriptions are: for all disinfection and sterilization services, the school can refer to Dubai Municipality's website for the accredited companies through the link that is shared by them, or contacting Dubai Municipality command room by dialing 800-4006. Common areas in the school, that is the toilet, pantries, waiting areas, etc., should be cleaned and disinfected every hour and after every use. This also applies to frequently used areas, surfaces such as doors, handles, dining tables, seat rests, elevators, keys, etc. Total sanitization of the school prior to the official opening is necessary. Daily cleanup and sterilization of all areas and surfaces of the school premises and effective sanitization post completion of each day to be conducted, and cleaning process to be in line with Dubai Municipality guidelines for schools. The Dubai Municipality cleaning and disinfecting guidelines for both daily routine disinfection and for terminal disinfection should be followed. Do not use cleaning disinfecting products that carry a danger or a corrosive label warning that may compromise the health and health of children and individuals with respiratory illness and medical conditions. Do not mix cleaners and disinfectants under any circumstances. Frequently touched areas, surfaces should be disinfected after every use to ensure the highest efficacy of disinfectant actions. Clear guidelines should be set for security staff and those who are cleaning the school facilities to ensure they follow the right measures, such as wearing gloves, masks, white while cleaning. Encourage strict hand washing regime and adequate hand washing breaks for children. Assist children with hand washing, especially younger children who cannot wash hands alone. Ensure hand sanitizers are distributed across the school premises away from younger children's reach. The sanitizers should be approved by Dubai Municipality. We continue. This is another slide for section D, hygiene. Anyone entering the premises should be checked for wearing mask and should be asked to use the hand sanitizer available at the entrance. The staff and the children's bags, shoes are encouraged to be sprayed with the sanitizers upon arrival to school. In classes where taking off shoes is required, a shoe rack should be designated outside the class entrance rather than taking them inside the classrooms. Frequently used electronic devices should get disinfected after every use, example tablets, computers, etc. Special requested restricted safety precaution measures, procedures and supervision procedures, special restricted safety precautionary measures, procedures and supervision procedures of to be maintained by a school towards subcontractors in charge of cleanup and hygiene service providers with regular assessments and their compliance. The school should encourage the paperless strategy and the elevated use of technology in the educational provision to minimize contacts. Place awareness educational posters describing hand washing steps near sinks, and additional guiding hygiene communication material should be shared with the parents prior to opening of school and should be placed across the premises, that is respiratory hygiene, distancing, etc. Measures should be taken to ensure that students with certain disabilities or learning difficulties receive adequate supervision and support when needed. Where possible, all spaces should be well ventilated using natural ventilation, opening windows or ventilation units. Ensure that cleaning services are punctual and thorough, and that is bins should be emptied frequently, etc. Ensure that all staff and children frequently wash their hands with soap water for 20 seconds and dry thoroughly. Review the guidance and hand cleaning. Clean their hands upon arrival at the setting before and after eating and after sneezing or coughing. Are encouraged not to touch their mouth, ears and nose. And the last point in this category is Dubai Municipality standards and waste management, especially contaminated waste, should be followed. This is section D. We proceed to the next section for awareness of health and safety protocols. Students are requested to use this in their literacy assignment and share it with family and friends. It is for awareness. Please do share this with family and friends so that you take care of everyone in your surrounding. We proceed to the next section. Section E, we move on to section E, that is restrictions. We are sharing the protocols for reopening of private schools in Dubai for awareness regarding health and safety. Kindly share it with family and friends, and students may use it for their assignment. Let's proceed. All staff visitors and students over the age of 6 are mandated to wear masks at all times inside the school. From entry, non-compliance will lead to denial of entry to this facility, school facility. Children over the age of 6, all students from grade 1 to year 1 and above will wear masks. Students and staff are with medical conditions are exempted from wearing a mask with a medical certificate. Only masks can be taken off during eating and during high intensity physical activities. Staff who are in direct contact with children are encouraged to wear transparent masks, face shields to enable lip reading and facial expression. School cleaners should wear gloves and masks while cleaning the facility. Sufficient stocks of masks, gloves and sanitizers must be available, and specially designated bins to throw used items as recommended by the relevant government authorities. Registration should be encouraged to happen online. If truly needed, parents, guardians visit for registration should be based on appointment system. It shouldn't be allowed during drop-off, pick-up and break time to avoid having the visits during children crowding time. The students are requested to share this with family and friends for health and safety awareness. It is not a matter of like or dislike. It's a matter of being socially responsible. Kindly we'll proceed with the next section by the time you share this with family and friends. We proceed to the protocols for reopening of private schools in Dubai with the section F, that is setup of physical distancing and arrangements. Ensure the 2 meters distancing measure is maintained in all common areas, service desks, etc., where different groups of students, staff and visitors are mixing. Classroom areas should support sufficient room for groups to maintain physical distancing of at least 1.5 meters per child in each classroom, provided everyone wears a mask. Ensure that toilets do not become crowded by limiting number of students who use toilet facilities at one time. Proceeding further with the continuation part of physical distancing and arrangement, use of outside space should be encouraged for exercise and breaks. For outdoor education, where possible, as this can limit transmission and more easily allowed for distance between children and staff. Outdoor equipment should not be used unless the setting is available to ensure that it is appropriately cleaned and sustained and sanitized between groups of children and young people using it, and that multiple groups do not use it simultaneously. Stagger the use of staff rooms and offices, their entry and exit, and the use of their pantry to limit occupancy. The administration, the school administration must dedicate an isolation room, separate room for nurse other than from the nurse room. Set procedures to handle COVID-19 suspects, confirmed cases, as well as the disinfection procedures as per the Dubai municipality guidelines. Pantries can be opened for usage by individuals strictly for food and drink consumption, maintaining a 2 meters physical distancing. No buffets or other forms of gatherings are allowed. Lockers are permitted as long as physical distancing measures are not compromised, and in such a way that each locker is designated to a specific student, alternated and not shared. Create visible markers on the floor to indicate appropriate spacing. All coffee stations should follow 2 meters physical distancing guidelines, and queuing is avoided. No water dispenser is allowed. All elevators must have markings on the floor that indicate physical distancing. Users must comply by standing on these markings. Contactless payments can be encouraged, yet cash payments are allowed. These are quite a few points for maintaining physical distancing arrangements. Students are requested to share this with family and friends for the sake of safety. Thank you. We proceed with the next part of it. Continuing with the next part of it, that is setup of physical distancing arrangements. Showers and changing rooms are not permitted. On the days where students have PE lessons, they must come to school in their full PE uniform. Vending machines, pantries and other packed food and beverages are allowed in the condition that they follow the necessary guidelines for the sector. Only disposable containers, frequent sanitization of machines and pantries items, maintaining 2 meters between the tables. Continuing to the next part, that is educational provision. Students ratios will vary depending on the size of the classroom. The school will have the liberty to decide on the number of students per class as long as the safe distance of at least 1.5 meters per child or person is maintained. Provision for students in pre-primary, that is FS1, KG1, FS2 and KG2 year 1, will require stable groups for 10 or fewer children. Stable means the same number of 10 or fewer children who are in the same group each day. The group of 10 must be cared for in a space that cannot be accessed by children outside the stable group. Keep cohorts together where possible and ensure that children and young people are in the same small learning groups at all times each day, and different groups are not mixed during the day or subsequent days. Ensure that the same teachers and the other staff are assigned to each learning group, and as far as possible these stay at the same during the day or on subsequent days. Recognizing the secondary settings where there will be some subject specific rotation. Class rotations are not permitted for curriculums featuring class rotations. Students should remain in a designated classroom while teachers rotate instead. Students should be designated a chair and table, and swapping among students is allowed. Students should be designated a chair and a table, and no swapping among students is allowed. At least one staff member holding a current certification in pediatric first aid and CPR needs to be available at all times. Proceeding further to section G, continued, that is students or staff with high risk conditions, specific illness and immunocompromise should be offered alternative education means, that is online provision, until further notice. The school has to ensure academic provision for all the students who are unable to attend their classes physically due to health conditions, isolated quarantines, etc. Proceeding to action H, that is special events. Cancel or postpone special events such as festivals, holidays, events, special performances, sports, tournaments until further notice. Group activities such as school trips, celebrations, sports and students camps should be suspended. Shared resources, materials, place awareness, educational posters explaining the rules for handling shared materials while maintaining constant disinfection after every use. Use of soft toys and the toys with the integrate parts or that are otherwise hard to clean should be avoided. All equipments in the classroom such as toys, to books, scissors, pens, pencils, crayons, art, crafts, materials, MSE play resources as well as role play and other materials should be sanitized after each and every single use where possible. All class items should be immediately removed if sneezed on, coughed on and put in mouth. Keep a designated clearly labeled basket container for separating items that have been in children's mouth, sneezed or coughed on, etc. Clean and sanitize prior to returning to the children's area. Students and teachers must bring their own exclusive stationery items, devices and gadgets, that is laptops, tablets and headphones, etc. Students should not share their stationery with your child. If the children need to supply of stationery, it should be done by the teacher via proper disinfection. Avoid using equipment that will require blowing musical instruments, whistles, blowpipe, etc. or encourage the parents to supply their children with their own equipment if possible. Teachers should provide soft copies of teaching and review materials and should encourage paperless work in class for homework. Digital handwriting and typing should be accepted for relevant homework. Proceeding to section I, that is shared resources and material, continued. Unnecessary materials, carpets, equipments and furniture should be removed from classrooms. Extracurricular activities are encouraged to be offered digitally. Certain types of play sections areas should be closed, that is dress up sections, indoor soft play areas, reading corners with soft furniture. Open areas should include furniture and equipment that is easy to clean. Toys and other common resources should not be shared with the other groups of students unless they are washed and sanitized before being moved from one group to the other. Proceeding to food and beverages, food catering at this stage should be restricted. The school can provide catering services provided it is based on the prepackaged food while following Dubai municipality guidelines related to catering services. Families are encouraged to supply food and beverage for their children along with their own plastic safe utensils. Staff must also bring in their own food and drink. Teachers should supervise to ensure that children do not share food. Face shields are encouraged during meal breaks when masks can be temporarily removed. If the school hosts a cafe, Dubai municipality's guidelines for cafes and restaurants should be followed, especially regarding capacity restrictions, physical distancing and the use of disposable items and hygiene across the venue and staff. Buffets and other forms of meal gatherings are not allowed. The school should implement staggered meal breaks that will ensure the safe minimum 1.5 meters distancing between students of the same class and 2 meters distancing between students of different classes. Water dispensers are not allowed. The school may offer sanitized water bottles. Pantries can be opened for use, for individual use. Strictly for food and drink consumption, maintaining 2.5 meters of physical distancing. Continuing to the section action area K, physical education, there are short descriptions are to ensure that students maintain active and keep healthy. Schools will resume physical education lessons with strict adherence to safety management measures. During PE lessons, students and PE teachers will not be required to wear masks when engaged in strenuous physical activities such as running and workout as long as they adhere to physical distancing measures. PE lessons should focus on sports that do not require physical interaction, and school swimming pools will remain closed until further notice. All staff and trainers who practice physical distancing of at least 1.5 meters during the PE lessons, create visible markers on the floor to indicate appropriate spacing. For schools with gym facilities and for running specific team sports and relevant guidelines for gyms are to be adhered and could be referred to through the Dubai Sports Council website. All health and safety guidelines and standards in all sports halls are in line with Dubai Municipality health and safety guidelines. Students should maintain physical distancing while entering PE halls and stadiums. Frequent sanitization of all equipments and all areas in which PE lessons are offered after every use and post closure of the school through proper sanitizing scheduled by temporarily closing PE halls. Encourage outdoor activities wherever possible. Ensure ventilation of gym either by opening windows and doors or by using ventilation systems. No tournaments or events will take place at this time. Students, kindly share this with family and friends. It's for your own and others' safety and precautions. We proceed to the next section. We proceed with the next section, that is the transportation. The short descriptions are: schools must use buses at half capacity and no place marker, and to place marks on chairs for seating guidelines. Anyone entering the bus should undergo temperature screening. Anyone with a temperature of 37.5 degrees centigrade should not be allowed on the bus. Bus assistants who are older than 60 years suffering from serious chronic diseases or who are immunocompromised should not be on duty. All bus riders with the exceptions of children younger than 6 years need to wear mask. Bus hygiene should be maintained by following the appropriate sanitization and physical distancing standards. For example, seat belts, armrest, handles, rails, etc. should be sanitized after each use in accordance with RTA's relevant guidelines for public transportation. Daily record keeping should be maintained by capturing all bus riders throughout daily transportation programs and trips. Absence should also be recorded. For buses using swipe cards for registration, the cards and the swipe machine should be constantly disinfected. The process should be supervised by the bus attendant. Adequate signage should be added inside the bus to guide children towards hygiene practices, that is respiratory hygiene, waste management, etc. Adequate waste management and disinfection practices should be followed, especially that children might use back seat pockets and bins. Ensure proper ventilation in the vehicles at all times. Avoid recirculating the air and encourage the use of windows whenever possible. We proceed as the transportation section continues to the next part of it. That is now, if a child begins to show symptoms of COVID-19 while taking the bus, the child is considered a probable COVID-19 case. The immediate measure is to ensure the child is seated at 2 meters away from the rest of the children, and the bus attendant should be immediately informed the health and safety in charge in the school, who should immediately communicate with the school administration and parents and guardians. If the trip was drop off at home, the child should be dropped off first. And if the trip was for drop off at school, the child should be isolated and sent home. The child should not return to school until the PCR result is obtained. If the result is negative, the child should not return to school until they are symptom free. If the result is positive, the traced contacts of the child, including staff and the other riders on the bus, are considered close contacts. They should all commence the 14-day quarantine counted from the day of the positive PCR test or form. Communications: ensure that sufficient and accessible training and communication channels are utilized to keep all staff, parents and children informed of new settings, practices and hygiene approaches for the start of the academic year. Adequate training should be provided to the health and safety in charge and the meeting nurse, doctor, to ensure proper handling of any potential cases. Students are requested to share this with family and friends for safety and awareness. We proceed to the next part. The next part is section N, readiness plan. All schools should fill the KHD online readiness template according to the stated deadline before school reopening. Schools must implement their approved readiness plan. These readiness plans ensure that there are appropriate procedures in place to safeguard the continuity of operations and the safety of everyone on the school premises in alignment with the endorsed guidelines. Schools must designate a hygiene officer, health and safety in charge, or a crisis response team to supervise the daily and continuous cleaning of the trained on the best practices and deemed requirements. We proceed further with the same. The compliance, that is section O, schools need to fully complete and comply with all the measures and guidelines stated by the government regulators. The school premises other than classrooms. Prayer rooms should remain closed until the government is allowing prayer rooms to open across the different facilities in Dubai. साइंस लेबोरेटरीज, ट्रेनिंग किचन्स, आर्ट स्टूडियोज, म्यूजिक रूम्स एंड अदर स्कूल इम्प्लीमेंट द फॉलोइंग गाइडलाइंस वेयर पॉसिबल. ऑल स्पेसेस शुड बी वेल वेंटिलेटेड यूजिंग नेचुरल वेंटिलेशन ओपनिंग विंडोज और वेंटिलेशन यूनिट्स. द रूम्स शुड नॉट बी used in full capacity to ensure that users maintain at least 1.5 meters distance during the class session. Frequently touched areas, surfaces and equipment should be disinfected after every use to ensure the highest efficacy of disinfectant action. Also, students should be encouraged to bring in their own equipment when possible. Clear guidelines should be set for cleaning staff to ensure they follow the right measures such as wearing gloves and masks while cleaning. Avoid using equipments that will require blowing musical instruments, whistles, blowpipes, etc. or encourage the parents to supply their child with their own equipment if possible. Food prepared during food technology classes should not be shared between students. We continue with the school premises other than classroom continued. Libraries should implement the following guidelines: staggered entry to the library, adequate cleaning and distance between lessons. Library lessons and reading corners must maintain the minimum 1.5 meters physical distancing between students in the same class and 2 meters otherwise. The librarian and support staff should be wearing masks, gloves and use hand sanitizers over gloves after each interaction. The library counter and equipment should be sanitized every hour. The teacher supervises the process of book viewing and selection to minimize children's touching of the books and the library equipment. Fabric-based books or books made with the material that is difficult to clean should be restricted. All used books should be placed in a clearly labeled designated container for disinfection before reuse. Schools are encouraged to laminate the books for ease of cleaning and disinfection. Library equipment and gadgets should be disinfected after every use and children should not share the equipment. Online search and browsing of books should be encouraged. A specific book collection area to be designated to limit physical search of books in the library. The book drop-off container should be designated and clearly labeled. Physical distancing of 2 meters, constant disinfection and limited use of equipment should be allowed into outdoor learning areas. We proceed further. I believe we have reached the last part of it. That's 118. Students are requested to share this with family and friends for the sake of safety and precautions. And students who are doing the literacy assignment are requested to use this piece of information for their literacy assignment for writing graphic organizer, paragraph writing, using transitional words and build paragraphs instead of bullet points or points as shown over here. I hope the students will take precautions and make the best use of this piece of information and spread this awareness with family and friends and be responsible social citizens. Thank you very much.